Number 1. Hidden Introverts. INFJs are in fact introverts. That's what the I in INFJ means. However, not many people see them as true introverts. This is because INFJs tend to be social chameleons, adapting themselves according to the situation they're in. This is why sometimes they're the center of the party because that's what they need to be at the moment. As introverts, however, they're the type of people who have no problem speaking to crowds but hate the idea of making small talk at a party. Number 2. Inconsistent with their affections. INFJs are, at their core, introverts. But they don't act like how many people think introverts act. They can enjoy social interactions and physical affections, especially with the ones they love. But sometimes, due to their introverted nature, they are just too overwhelmed to deal with other people and might retreat into solitude for a while. This might be confusing to their partner, who might think that they did something wrong to warrant the cold shoulder, when in fact, it's a natural part of INFJs and something they need to do as a way of coping with stressful situations. Number 3. Unwavering convictions. INFJs have certain ideas and beliefs that they hold on to very tightly. These ideas and beliefs are, according to them, for the betterment of society. Though they may be great ideals, INFJs' unwavering convictions to them can also harm them. They're not willing to bend or compromise, and they prefer to be in relationships with people who readily agree with their view of the world. This can make them appear to other people as being quite stubborn in their beliefs. Number 4. Tight-knit friend group. INFJs have no problem introducing themselves to others and understand that it's important to keep in contact with these people. But despite all that, or maybe because of it, they choose to have a very small, tight-knit group of people that they truly would call friends. The upside of this is that INFJs are extremely loyal to their chosen group no matter what. The downside? It's difficult to get to really know them. Number 5. Hard to get close to. Yes, INFJs are social chameleons that can easily adapt to social situations and often appear as extroverts to other people despite their introverted nature. They're, however, very guarded about who they are. Because INFJs are idealists living in a non-idealist world, they're often shunned for what they think. Since they also have difficulty verbalizing their thoughts, they can also come across as insensitive or absurd when they speak about their ideals. That's why they've learned to keep their true inner self to themselves and only show them to those they trust. Number 6. Always seeking the truth. INFJs are always seeking to get to the truth or the core of the matter. They want to decipher the genuine, real reasons behind things. Through their life experiences of continually seeking the truth, they become real experts at reading people. They have a gift for knowing when someone is lying to them. INFJs' expertise comes from them having a real thirst for new knowledge. This helps them gain a better understanding of the world, whether it's attending conferences, reading a new book, or traveling the world to experience new cultures. Number 7. They're very empathetic. Due to their truth-seeking nature, INFJs gain insight into how and why people behave the way they do. This makes them highly empathetic to those around them. Whether they're aware of it or not, they are able to discern the true nature of a person's behavior. This is why they're also very forgiving, as they're able to tell whether someone is truly malicious or if other factors made them behave that way. Number 8. They hate small talk. INFJs hold the truth in high regard. That's one of the reasons they hate small talk so much. They only see this as meaningless chatter and a waste of time. They would rather get straight to the point and fill their conversations with meaningful and insightful discussions. They know that you can't just start a conversation with a question, "What is the meaning of life?" But they'd rather keep the small talk as short as possible before getting to the meaty part. Number 9. High achievers and people pleasers. There's nothing INFJs hate more than failure. The only other thing that they might hate even more is disappointing someone. Because of these two things, they tend to be high achievers and also people pleasers. This drives them to work hard and excel at whatever they attempt to do. Unfortunately, this does come with some negative sides. INFJs tend to have a difficult time receiving criticism. They can perceive it as a huge failure on their part, even if the criticism is given in a constructive way. Number 10. They excel at writing. INFJs love to spend time alone. They can sometimes have difficulty expressing themselves verbally. These two things combine to make INFJs excel at language, especially the written word. The time they spend alone is often used to read books to enrich their mind. This in turn helps them communicate the thoughts in their mind through their writing. When combined with their creative nature, it's no surprise that many INFJs turn to become creative writers. Number 11. They can make emotional decisions. This can happen to INFJs usually due to two main reasons. They are either super excited about a new idea they've had, and due to their passion, they leap into decisions too quickly. This could be, for example, spending a large sum of money on a new training course without looking if there were cheaper options. On the other hand, it can also happen when they are exhausted after a tiring or trying day. This exhaustion can make them feel that they hate everything, even something they loved yesterday. This can lead them to making over-the-top emotional decisions. That's why INFJs need to learn to take care of themselves and keep harmony in their life. When they feel these emotions and passions rising, they must take a time out to rebalance their emotional state. Number 12. They are deep thinkers. Being deep thinkers, INFJs are always pondering what their purpose is in life. They love to sit down and think about the bigger meaning in their lives and the things that surround them. That's why many of them become researchers or philosophers. Unfortunately, this can get the best of them, and they get sucked into a void where they think everything is heavy and super serious. They need to be reminded every now and then that they need to relax and enjoy life for what it is. Number 13. They are focused on the big picture. Some people focus on what's before them and can barely see anything beyond that. That's not how INFJs operate. They always have the big picture in mind, always a few steps ahead of the rest. This makes them great planners, as they can see not only the end goal, but the steps needed to reach that goal. They are the type that have big dreams they want to achieve. But being able to see so wide means they're unable to see the minute detail. Though they might be able to see the steps needed to reach their goal, they're often unable to see the minutiae of the situation. They're also often so focused on the future, they don't realize that there might be some present situations that need to be dealt with. Number 14. Always willing to help. INFJs are excellent fixers. This applies to both material goods and the people around them. Just as much as they're willing to spend the time to fix a broken machine, they also will take the time to fix a broken person. This comes from their ability to see beyond the surface facts into the core of the being. They might see a flawed person and see the good in them. They'll use their own time and money to help them out however they can. However, unlike a lifeless, broken machine, a person might behave in completely unexpected ways, leading the INFJs to feel frustrated and defeated if something goes wrong. Number 15. They're great counselors. Because of their intuitive, empathic nature, INFJs often become the go-to person to be sounding boards for personal problems. People seek INFJs to help them out with problems or seek advice about their situations. In turn, INFJs, with their truth-seeking insight and empathy, do give great solutions. Due to their expertise in this area, they can get stressed by frequent requests for help and advice from others. Though they might feel somewhat bothered by this unintentional therapist role, deep down they're glad that they are able to help someone in need. Number 16. They can't stand conflict. There are a few reasons why INFJs despise conflicts. This is partly due to them being people pleasers, but the biggest reason is the fact that they're so empathetic. This makes INFJs very understanding of both sides of the conflict. They see that both sides usually have good intentions, but for some reason, they can't see eye to eye. This frustrates INFJs to the point that they try to avoid conflict as much as they can. INFJs get confused as to which side they pick or if they should even pick a side at all because of this empathy. They would rather rush to agree with one side or another just to get it over with. However, INFJs also tend to dwell on these situations and may later regret the things they've done and said. Subscribe so we can continue to make videos like these. Make sure to check out this playlist of my other videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care!